Look at this. Penn State, 11 wins and no losses, first in all the major polls, the only Division 1A team to go undefeated. Alabama lost one time to USC in Birmingham, but since that time they've rolled them off. This is a dream matchup, only the fifth time that 1 and 2 in the polls have met on the field. The past history of this kind of matchup reflected there. The Rose Bowl, the Cotton Bowl, the Rose Bowl, and the last time it happened was the 1972 Orange Bowl. The bands, the people, the flavor, the ambiance, call it what you want. Let's call it, for the sake of one word, spirit. You'll never find a group of people more intensely interested than the group of people who are gathered here in the Superdome, because so many of them have come from so far away to see their favorite team play. And it's the first time that Penn State really has ever had a chance to go on the field and win their first national championship. Hello, everybody. I'm Keith Jackson. And talking about this national championship, let's define it this way. If the undefeated Nittany Lions win this ball game today, it seems a virtual certainty they will be accorded the posture as national champions. If Alabama should win today, it would appear that we'll have to wait until all the voting is done in the polls and they are published. Because if Alabama wins today, you know that USC, for one, has a rightful claim for some degree of recognition in that area. You also know that Oklahoma, if they should defeat Nebraska, will be in a position to claim some first-place votes as well. So that's pretty much the simplest definition we can give you. But I will tell you this, that when we had the preseason polls before the first game was played, Alabama was picked to be number one and Penn State was picked to be number three. But that was a long time ago. Now we're going to settle the issue on the field of play. And let's begin as Jim Lampley talks with the two quarterbacks, a conversation recorded earlier, Chuck Yucena and Jeff Rutledge.
Chuck, from a competitive standpoint, this is obviously the most important game Penn State has played as a team in some time. As you look at it personally, how do you judge the importance of this game for you?
Well, without saying, it probably is the most important game in Penn State history, being because we have the chance to win the national championship on the field. There have been other big games in Penn State, as in 72 and 69, they've had big Orange Bowl wins, but then again, after the wins, that we didn't get a number one ranking. We feel at Penn State that if we can win this game, there should be no question that we could be number one. And therefore, I think we're not only going to be playing for ourselves, but for those teams that just got edged out, and for all other teams at Penn State who never got the chance to play for a national championship.
So you're playing for the identity of Penn State as a football program in all the years under Paterno, and not just to prove that this team is the best in the country right now.
I think in a way we are. You know, we want to win this national championship for our team. That's our first priority. But all those other teams that we felt at Penn State were a little slighted. I think they'll be celebrating this win as much as we will.
Jeff, it's an understatement to say that this is an important game, but what does the goal of a national championship and the fact that a national championship may hinge on the outcome of this game mean to you individually?
Well, that was the main reason I came to the University of Alabama to begin with, was the chance to play for a national championship. And here it is, my fourth year, my senior year, and it's finally here. And you know, playing Penn State is certainly an honor and a privilege to, you know, they rank number one in the nation. And that's what football is all about, to reach the highest possible goal you can reach. And, you know, the winner of this game will probably be the national champion. And, you know, that's what it's all about. That's the reason I came to the University of Alabama. And hopefully, when the game's over, you know, I can say I played on the national championship football team.
The quarterbacks, Chuck Yucena and Jeff Rutledge, both very good passers, both imaginative quarterbacks. And they have plenty of people to call on offensively. First, let's have a look at the ground troops that Penn State will be showing you today. Number 48, running at tailback, is Booker Moore. He's a sophomore, 207-pounder. He was second on the team in rushing this year with 602 yards, scored 6 touchdowns, caught 16 passes, and may be the fastest of the Penn State backs. Sharing the tailback work with him is Mike Gooman. Number 24, he's a junior, 210-pounder. One of the more versatile athletes on the field. He started last year for Penn State as a defensive back. This year moved back over to tailback, where he ran for 351 yards. The fullback, number 32, Matt Sui. And he is the tough runner. Ran for 720 yards. He's also a good receiver with 26 catches. He scored 7 touchdowns this year. And he's a little quicker than the first glance might reveal. He does have 4-5 speed. Moving to the wide receiver position, you have an outstanding athlete, number 46, Scott Fitzke. He holds the school career record for touchdown catches with 11. He is also the team punter with a 36-yard average, and he is very dangerous when he goes deep. Now, there is another young man who wears the number 10, who has to figure heavily in everybody's plans. Look at the stat, 18 out of 19 within 40 yards in the field goal. Holds virtually all of the kicking records. Alabama, good ground troops there too. For example, let's look at the left halfback out of the wishbone. They call him Touchdown Tony Nathan. He's homegrown right in Birmingham. He is just 3 yards short of his 2,000 mark for his career, and he has played a lot through all 4 years of his career. Very steady football player with enormous ability, and he can break the long run almost anywhere and any time. At fullback, starting is Steve Whitman. He's a big, solid fellow at 235 pounds and a very good blocker, but he's finally playing on healthy legs for the first time in a long time, and he is double trouble pounding up the middle. There is a youngster on the right side of the wishbone, number 42, a sophomore, Major Ogilvy. He has delivered so many big plays for Alabama this season. 186-pounder, but he runs harder than that. He's a very difficult fellow to bring down. Wide receiver number 4, Keith Pugh, one of the most acrobatic people I've ever seen at this position. He had 20 catches this season, and he will share the work at wide receiver today with senior Bruce Bolton. Those are some of the offensive people, and right now the Nittany Lions of Penn State have entered the Superdome, led by their coach, Joe Paterno. The record you can see, the Lions started slowly, tough game against Temple. Along the way, they had some other tough moments, but toward the end of the season, they were very solid, beating good football teams, and here comes Alabama. One time to USC in the third game of the season, 24-14, won all the rest of them. Had some close calls, but the Bear praised his young people for their audacity, for the willingness to ignore the circumstances that made life difficult for them, and they just kept on winning. And here they are with a chance, they feel, to win a national championship. Working with us as analyst and commentator today, Mr. Frank Broyles. And Frank, we've talked considerably now about the offense, but you and I both know that Joe Paterno and Bear Bryant build their football teams on defense.
Well, Penn State is the best defensive football team in the country. The reason is, Keith, they play hard and aggressive against the run. In fact, they try to shut it down completely. And when they do, watch out. Here comes a big rush that demoralizes most offensive units. But I should point out that this is the first time in 3 years that Penn State has faced the wishbone attack.
We have 3 All-American defensive tackles out on the field today. 2 of them play together in the Penn State line, Matt Millen and Bruce Clark.
General Bob Nealon of Tennessee, Keith, used to say that the Lord is on the side of the team with the 2 best tackles. And these 2 at Penn State are outstanding. They can disrupt any offensive running attack and then put extreme pressure on the passer.
Alabama offers you Marty Lyons and some ferocious linebackers.
Yes, Marty Lyons leads the team, strangely enough, as a down lineman in tackles at 112, and Barry Krause is also an All-American, and he's big and strong and tough and knows how to play against the run.
What then can we expect in the way of offensive tactics?
Well, Alabama feels that they must use a variety of formations to play against this strong Penn State defense. They feel like if they can shift and use man in motion, they can keep the defense off balance. And then, Keith, they have a chance to set up the key play in the wishbone attack. That's the fullback handoff. If they don't do this, they won't have a chance to run wide or throw much.
One of the things that we have here, other than the fact that we have 2 very good football teams about to play each other, ranked 1-2, we have 2 great coaches across the field from each other.
Very definitely, Keith. Joe Paterno is one of the great football coaches this nation has ever seen. He stands for the things that we love in athletics. People admire and respect him, his players love him, and he's a winner in every respect. And Bear Bryant, in the coach's opinion, I think everybody, is the greatest motivator of people the game has ever seen. Year after year, Keith, he can come up with a great football team. His teams never see complacency. They give their very best when their best is needed.
That's enough conversation. Let's play the game. We'll have the kickoff for you right after this. Alabama Crimson Tide, having won the toss, and Ogilvy is brought down by Giuseppe Harris as he reached the 20-yard line. Here is the offensive backfield for the Crimson Tide of Alabama. These pictures were taken at the Court of Two Sisters. The quarterback is the senior, Jeff Rutledge. Tony Nathan opens at halfback. Major Ogilvy is the other halfback. And Steve Whitman is the fullback, and they're all from Birmingham. And Bruce Bolton will open at wide receiver. He's a senior from Memphis. Whitman in motion, the pitch to Nathan, a sweep to the left side. The Penn State defense blowing with it from the 20. They bring him down up around the 24. The offensive front, the big guys for Alabama's offense, they break down this way. Buddy Adelette, number 78, is a tackle. Mike Brock, 235. Dwight Stevenson, one of the best centers in the country. Vince Booth, Jim Bunch out of Mechanicsville, Virginia, and Rick Neal is the tight end. It is second down and 6 yards to go for Alabama. The ball is given inside to Nathan, and Nathan is up to the 27. We have a Big 8 officiating crew here working this ball game. The defensive setup for Penn State. Those are the officials, Bill Jennings, the chief, the referee, Cliff Squires, Frank Ellis, John McClinnock, Dan Upson, and Ed Shannon. And we have Tony Nathan shaken up on the play. He's coming slowly off the field, dragging a leg. So on his second carry in the ball game, Nathan takes a whack. And Lou Eichner, number 30, will go in the tailback to replace him. Tony coming off under his own power, but he appears to be hurting considerably. So we will watch that development. Jim Lampley is with us on the sidelines, and he will have the information for you. From the 27, it is third down and 3. Rutledge gives inside to his fullback, Whitman. And Whitman banging away, trying to reach the 30, and it appears that he may well have gotten his first down. The Penn State defensive people up front, it's Larry Coopin, Bruce Clark, Tony Petruccio, Matt Millen, and Joe Lally. The linebackers for Penn State, Paul Suey, Lance Mayle, and Rich Malott. And the defensive secondary, Mike Gilson, Carl McCoy, and Pete Harris. Pete Harris, top interceptor in the country, had a great season. The ball is just beyond the 30, where it is first down now for Alabama. And Frank Broyles, they were able to get movement that time up the middle from their fullback. Tony Nathan is out of the lineup, dragging his leg. Whitman carries over the left side, and Jeff Rutledge, the Alabama quarterback, took a pretty good lick after he had handed the ball away. The gain is 1 yard. They're icing down the hip of Tony Nathan, as you see there, so we'll check it. May have a bruise, he could have a hip corner. Whatever, he's out of the lineup. Eichner in motion, Rutledge rolling for the first pass. Bruce Clark throws him down, and Rutledge unloads it. And there's the big guy we were talking about. At the 31-yard line, as you see, the big guy just roaring through, and it's a virtual impossibility, and we've got a little trouble with Frank Broyles' microphone here right now, but it's virtually impossible to block him one-on-one. Bolton comes out of the lineup for Alabama. The wide receiver now is Keith Pugh, number 4. It is third down and 9 from the 31. Rutledge, an obvious passing down, gets good protection, throws it to Eichner. Eichner comes across the 37, but he is cut down there, unable to reach the first down marker at the 40-yard line. So good defensive flow by Penn State. And now Alabama will come up with the first punt.
I believe that Rutledge got a good taste of what the pass rush at Penn State has had all year long. It's devastating.
Mike Gooman and Matt Suey, double deep, to receive the punt of Woody Humphrey. The left-footed kicker, hangs up, beauty. Gooman over, calls fair catch. Humphrey knocks it out of bounds, or ignore it, kick back inbounds, and continues to roll downfield to the 12-yard line. He was looking for the coffin corner. He didn't get it, but he got it deep enough at the 12. Here's Jim to tell us about Tony Nathan.
You take a look at Tony Nathan along the sidelines. He's still being worked on by Alabama trainer Jim Goostree. They say it's a bruise in the top part of the hip. He doesn't seem to be hurt on the outside part of the hip in the hip pointer area. They're putting ice on him. They hope he'll be ready to go back in and play shortly, but they're not certain how long it'll take. Bear Bryant came over and took a look.
Thank you, Jimmy. First down from Penn State, their first possession. Mike Booman out of the tailback position. Penalty flag thrown by the referee in the behind the Penn State backfield as Booman cuts it up to the 20-yard line.
Keith, Penn State came out in an unbalanced line, the first play of the ball game, to try to upset Alabama's defense. The play was successful, but holding by the offense.
We told you this is a neutral group of officials. They're all from the Big 8 Conference. The Penn State offensive backfield, let's take a look at them while Alabama discusses the penalty call against the Nittany Lions. Chuck Fusina is the quarterback. Booker Moore will share tailback with Mike Gooman. Matt Zui, the fullback, and Bob Bassett, a flanker. Scott Fitzke, the wide receiver, or split in, and the punter. They'll march him off half the distance, putting the ball back very close to the 6-yard line, where it'll be first down and 15 for the Nittany Lions. End off goes to Goodman. Comes up over the top to the 9, where he is grabbed and dragged down by Ricky Gilliland, 92, defensive linebacker, the Penn State offensive front. Herb Pankey is a tight end, converted from tackle. Keith Dorney is the big guy up front. Eric Cunningham, Chuck Corral is the center for Penn State. Jim Romano, a very good sophomore guard. Jim Brown, a very good sophomore tackle. Second down and about 13. The ball goes to Matt Sewer to the sideline. Hard to bend Sewer back, but that time Alabama got enough of him to hold him right at the 15-yard line. Coming across Marty Lyons and Wayne Hamilton to make the tackle. Hamilton and De Niro are the ends. They're both playing less than whole. Marty Lyons and Byron Braggs the tackles, and Warren Lyles, a freshman, is the middle guard. The linebackers are Barry Krause and Ricky Gilliland. The defensive secondary for Alabama, McNeil, Crumley, Legg, and Harris. Jim Bob Harris is a freshman, replacing Ricky Tucker, who is out with injury. Chuck Fusina on an option, chooses to pull it down, gets it out to the 20, fumbles the football. Alabama's defensive flow, fierce. Penn State does retain possession.
Keith, on a passing down, Alabama went to double coverage. Here's the rollout pass. They had one receiver deep, one short, both covered. Fusino had to turn up the field, run the football. But the ball was knocked loose, but they did recover.
McGriff knocked it loose. Gooman recovered it. And Ogilvie's back to receive the punt from Scott Fitzke. Gets it away. And Major calls fair catch for Alabama up at the 44-yard line. So the Crimson Tide will have good field position for their second offensive possession of the ball game. Tony Nathan has been wrapped a little more, and he's been jogging around. Now you see him running, loosening up well back of the bench to see how the hip feels. It's in the hip area, and as Jim Lampley told us, a bruise, not a pointer. We expect that we'll see Tony again before this ball game is done. First down, Alabama, from the 44-yard line. No score, first quarter. Rutley, options outside. Ogilvie, he's hit behind the line of scrimmage by Joe Lally, number 84. There was good pressure from the inside, Frank, and here come the Penn State defensive ends. And we saw these two fellas against Maryland have big ball games, Cuban and Lally.
Well, Joe Paterno, Keith, has always believed in forcing the offense. He, on early downs, he's going to play aggressive and put all the pressure he can. Lally came flying across on the option play and collision the ball carrier for a loss. An outstanding play on his part.
Tony Nathan is back in the lineup for Alabama at left halfback, out of the wishbone, with Whitman the fullback and Ogilvie on the right side. Rutledge looks, throws back across the field, set up a fullback screen over there with Whitman carrying. He's across midfield, and for the first time, Alabama is playing football on Penn State's end of the field. Tremendous blocking by Adelette and Brock. Watch them, 78 and 70.
Keith, this is a misdirect screen. The key to it is the acting of Rutledge going all the way over the right, throwing very dangerously across the field, but the defense had reacted as they would expect, and Whitman makes an outstanding run, lowers his shoulder, gets the extra yardage, and is close to a first down.
Just a little bit short as the referee, Bill Jennings, will bring it back into the hash mark. Tony Nathan back in the lineup, having suffered a bruised hip, but he ran on the field, and this is the kind of a football game where you're not going to let a little hurt stop you from playing in it. I'll
absolutely not. You're going to be out there if you possibly can.
Double tight end alignment now with Neil and Tim Travis in there. Nathan oftentimes is the money man in this call. Rutledge pitches it back. He almost dropped it. Nathan gets outside. He's healthy. First down, Alabama. He's inside the 40 to the 39-yard line. The Alabama backfield, the yardage total may not be that impressive per man, but look at the average per carry.
The reason it's not impressive total-wise, Keith, is they have four running backs. Most of the I-formation teams, the tailback, will carry the ball 30, 35 times, but then the wishbone is evened out across the backfield if they have success, and they are good, this Alabama football team.
So off a near mistake, Rutledge salvages it, and Nathan gets the first down at the Penn State 39. Jeff handles it clean this time, turns it up inside. And he'll do that. He'll stick his head in there, and especially if those big defensive linemen of Penn State are coming so hard, they overrun him.
Keith, it appears that the defensive strategy is bring Millen and Clark through the gap. This is what he did against Texas in the Cotton Bowl a few years ago, and they disrupt anything down the line of scrimmage if you don't double-team them.
And those numbers you just saw tell you how stingy they are on the ground. It is second down and about 7 yards to go, and Major Ogilvie rams it down to the 33-yard line where Bruce Clark makes the tackle.
Penn State's defense has five men lined up to play the run on both sides of the football. Here's Clark. You can see the quickness and the agility of this man. He was away from the play. No one blocked him. He goes right down the line and makes the tackle.
Number 54.
He was a linebacker as a freshman, Keith, and started six games. That shows his quickness.
Third down and four for Alabama at the Penn State 33. Rutledge to throw it. Rubin after him. He gets it away. It is dropped by Whitman. Whitman had the ball in his hands. He had Rick Neal there to block for him. He might very well have scored. He looked the other way and didn't look the ball into his hands, and Alabama misses the first down.
That was a golden opportunity to make a big play, Keith, and possibly score. It was a wonderful fake by Rutledge, fooled the defense, and Neal was going across the field and was wide open. He threw a little bit on behind him, and Whitman was right there but dropped it.
We've got the field goal try now for Alabama, and doing the kicking will be Alan McElroy. He will hit it out of Kevin Jones' hold. It is a 51-yard field goal try. Short. That's the first time this season that McElroy has tried a field goal of 50 yards or more. He missed it. 7:44 to go, first quarter, no score.
No, I honestly...
Inside the Superdome, 72 degrees. Outside, it's about 50 degrees and raining and kind of damp and cold. But all across the country, there is some real tough weather. Dallas, for example, chill factor of minus 10, snow, ice, just about everything you could want that's uncomfortable over there today. The upper Middle West, we're told, is being battered by a winter storm. So we feel very fortunate to be inside the dome for this 79 Sugar Bowl game. Penn State gets the ball at the 33, the line of scrimmage. Since they missed the kick under the rules, they get it back out where it was snapped from. And Fusina goes over the middle. He's got Bassett. And Bassett has the ball first down at the Alabama 49-yard line. Brought down by Ricky Gilliland. 18-yard gain.
Keith, that was an outstanding throw by Fusina. He drops back, fakes to the tailback to try to freeze the linebacker. Bassett, number 81, breaking in front of the safety man, right on target. Hurries back, catches it, and makes a big reception.
First down just over midfield for Penn State. The first time they've had the ball in Alabama territory. Matt Sury takes a wallop from Gilliland, 92. Just nailed him right on the letters.
Alabama's linebackers stacked in behind their defensive guards and tackles where offensive blockers cannot get to them. And when you run straight ahead, they are likely to hit you on many occasions, just like Gilliland did right there.
McGriff, 96, is in at the middle guard position, or nose guard for Alabama now. Second down and 9. No contact. Alabama is back. Hussein, a deep drop for the long pass. Goes over the middle. Pass intercepted by Murray Lane at the 33-yard line. A diving grab by the strong safety of Alabama. The pass was intended for Booker Moore. He scooped it right off the carpet. Here comes Barry Cross, Frank, putting a lot of heat on Fusina. I think Chuck might have had to throw it before he wanted.
He ran right through and forced him to move just a little bit to the left, and Fusina was off balance. It would have been better had he not thrown the ball. It was way off target, but look at the interception that Legg makes right there. He's all Southeastern Conference this year.
At his first down, Alabama. The football is just outside the 33-yard line. Rick Neal wired to the right. Rutledge stands up and throws at him, and he can't hang on. The ball thrown behind him. He tried to one-hand it. Carl McCoy defending for Penn State.
Here again, Bear says he's going to have to throw play-action passes on early downs to try to keep Millen and Clark from just running back and disrupting his offense. Neal was open, Keith, but he missed him.
6 minutes and 40 seconds, and you can see that Penn State has been a relatively careful football team. Only 21 turnovers this season. They don't make that many mistakes. Bolton is wide to the right. Nathan on the left side. They hand it inside to Overby. Good blocking behind the left guard and center. And he crosses the 40 to the 43. Dwight Stevenson, the center for Alabama, number 57, is a whale of a football player. He's a big guy, 6'3", 230-pound junior out of Hampton, Virginia. And he's about as good as you'll see at that position.
The Alabama coaches say he could be the best blocker in the history of their school, and to have him at center is an added bonus for this wishbone attack.
Third down, they need a little bit less than a yard, and Rutledge rides to his fullback, and Whitman breaks it. Steve Whitman goes down inside the Penn State 45-yard line. I told you at the very beginning that Steve is playing on two sound legs for a change, and with 235 pounds and a hat strapped on tight, he's tough.
Let's look at it, Keith. It's the first phase of the triple option. He's right on his seam path. He gets hit the line of scrimmage, but he is a determined football player. 235 pounds, gets in the secondary, and makes a big play. Very key for them to have that success early in the ball game inside.
That's the key to the wishbone. 44-yard line of Penn State. Rutledge, second man. Eichner finds some room outside. And a penalty flag goes down. Man on the sidelines threw the flag.
Penn State players say it's against Alabama. They're pointing backwards, so that's a tough break for Alabama.
Talking there to the defensive captain, that is Paul Suey, the brother of Matt Suey. A clip. 15-yarder coming up against the Crimson Tide. And that gets Bear moving around a little because they seemingly had some momentum going.
Two outstanding runs, Keith, by Ogilvie from the high formation
tailback. He just cut through there and on his own effort made the play. Watch Stevenson, number 57. He's one of the outstanding blockers. You can see he comes in high on the nose man and keeps his feet. We call that locking on, maintaining position, and not falling on your face. Stevenson is a great one.
The football moved back to the Penn State 49-yard line now, where it's first down and 15. They're really getting some room over the left side of that Penn State defensive front. Lance Mayo made the tackle, but Ogilvie had a lot of convoy to get him through there.
He was from the I formation again, which means that you can turn and pitch the ball. He's closer to the end run. He has great speed and determination. The end run wasn't there. When he turned up with a burst of speed and determined to run through blockers, and he did. 10-yard gain.
Billy Jackson replacing Steve Whitman for a play, but Whitman is now back. So you have Nathan, Ogilvie, and Whitman. They break the bone, go to the I formation, and send Nathan wide to the left side. Ogilvie, spinning around, looked to me like he wanted to work a little flea flicker. I think he wanted to get that ball back to his quarterback, but the Penn State defensive people didn't give him time.
Lance Mell, the linebacker number 56, is an outstanding football player, the leading tackler. He played nose guard last year, so in the line he has a good knack of going through, and he tackled Ogilvie before he could ladder the ball back. Keith, you're exactly right. It was a flea flicker play with Neal down deep in the behind the safety man.
It is third down now for Alabama at the Penn State 42-yard line. Neal goes out as a flanker. Rutledge hands it off inside to the fullback. Whitman reaches the 38. There he goes down in a heap. Again, Mayo is involved on the tackle, along with Bruce Clark, number 54.
I feel that they were running on third down, thinking that they would get a big blitz and maybe have a chance to surprise Penn State and pop up the middle. But at least they didn't drop back for a pass and get thrown for a big loss like a lot of teams did all season long against this great Penn State defense.
Art Stevenson has come out now. That means it is punting time, and Don Jacobs, who is a specialist at killing the ball deep, he can hit the knuckleball. Now he comes running up. He goes, he's a quarterback. He's moved up into the quarterback position, and there's a penalty flag, and that's too much time. So here was a gadget play, and he used too much time. He had to get it on a quick snap to get it away, but if they're going to punt the ball anyhow now, I'm sure, relatively academic.
They were going to run a play, Keith. What they were doing, they had gotten Penn State to substitute their punting return team and taken their regular defense out. And so they were going to fake a punt, run up, run a play, and hopefully make a first down. Bears one of the best at gadget plays in the history of this game.
Nobody has caused the rules to be rewritten more than Paul Bryant.
Tell me about it. I've been on the committee.
Humphrey hits a beauty. High hanger, and it bangs into the end zone. Instead of ricocheting toward the corner, it bounced straight in, a 43-yard punt. We have 3 minutes and 13 seconds to play in the first quarter. No score. Joe Paterno, the head football coach at Penn State University. Fine man. Paul Bear Bryant, almost, well, he's a legend. The head man at Alabama. Penn State's ball, first down at the 20. Bassett goes in motion. Made a mistake. The left side of the line jumped Jim Brown, number 75, jumped before the ball was snapped. Illegal procedure against the Lions, and that gets a grimace from the head coach. Worth pointing out, I think, that Alabama against the Penn State defense has run for 67 yards already. And if you remember, Penn State allowed only a little more than 54 per game during the season.
In fact, one team, Keith, rushed for over 100 yards. Syracuse got 113. But the reason is, I think, is that Penn State has not seen the wishbone at all. And it takes a little while to get accustomed and adjusted to the speed that the wishbone possesses.
First down and 15 from the 15 for Penn State. Same motion by Bassett. Fusina gives to the up man out of the eye. And Sui bangs in there for a couple of yards up to maybe the 18. Call it second down and 7 and 3 minutes to go in the first quarter. And it's a tight, tense defensive football game right now. Both teams, however, have shown us that they have brought some funny-looking plays.
They both have. Penn State's been handicapped with two penalties on two of their three possessions deep in their territory. Tough to make a first down after you get a penalty down in danger zone.
Second down and 12. Fusina going to go deep with it. Throwing for Fitzke, and it is incomplete. Defending is Alan Crumley, number 17. He ran all the way with it. They got a little tangled up going down the sidelines, but the official was right with him.
We can see Fitzke going on the deep pattern. He's going to try to test Crumley, who is noted to be kind of slow of foot, you might say. And you see a little pushing and shoving there. If it's accidental, most of the time the officials will ignore it unless the ball is right there. It was way overthrown. The officials thought it was not interference.
And so for Penn State, it is third down and 12 from their own 18-yard line with 2.5 minutes to go in the first quarter. We get a new football. That young man there is Ricky Tucker, but he was injured in an easy workout the other day, a freak accident. And he is the free safety for this ball club and a very important figure. And they're going to miss him, I bet you, before the day's done. Fusina does not get back to the 20. So they'll have to kick it away from the 19-yard line as Byron Braggs, the big sophomore, ran down the Penn State quarterback.
I think the Penn State coaches felt that Fusina was going to have a great day hitting the third down passes, the critical situations, but he has not so far in the game.
Pitsky to punt. He'll hit it from about his 13. Major Ogilvy is deep. Alabama's going to get good field position here. Ogilvy receiving it at the 42. Knocked down back at the 41. Good downfield coverage by the Nittany Lions. 92 Rick Donaldson down there. And this Saturday on ABC's Wide World of Sports Live from Honolulu, the Hula Bowl at 4 Eastern, 3 Central, and 1 Pacific. And they have a tremendous gathering of athletes to participate in this year's Hula Bowl. Just look at those names. That's a who's who in college football of 78. Just beyond the 41 of Alabama, first down for the Tide. Fullback Whitman is in motion. That is Nathan to the outside. Matt Millen is after him. He outruns him. And he breaks it big. Alabama is running against Penn State. That play goes all the way to the 42. Good for 16 yards.
Keith, that was the quick flip, the quick pitch to Nathan. Watch it right here, but you'll see the key is Whitman's block. And the key also being Nathan's faking inside, setting up his block right there by Whitman. Freeze him into the secondary and watch him lower that shoulder like a good back. Sure, that's outstanding football player, Tony Nathan, who averaged 6.9 all his career at Alabama.
Rick Neal shaking on the play. He will come off the field, but you can see he's walking easily and is certain to be all right. Tim Travis replaces him, a 212-pound junior from Bessemer. Bessemer's right in the Birmingham area. Nathan now has gained 31 yards on four carries. It is Alabama's ball, first down at the Penn State 42 with a minute 34 to go in the first quarter. No score. Maybe a checkoff and an audible here as Rutledge took a long time, gave it to his fullback, and Whitman takes it to the 38-yard line of Penn State. Most of the football game has been played on Penn State's end of the field.
The reason is that Penn State cannot make a first down while they're deep on their end of the field, and when you punt the football, then Alabama has very good field position. Penn State jumped into a 5-3 on that occasion right now, and that was the first time they've used it, and here's Notre Dame leading Houston 6-0 in the first quarter.
Second down, 6 from the 38. Rutledge got it, turned back inside, and he is thrown down by Fred Ragucci, number 83, defensive end.
Keith, what happened on that play is most interesting. I'd like to point out, they were in a 5-3 the play before. They hit the handoff. This time, they showed him the 5-3, moved over into an overshift, and Matt Millen came flying through and disrupted everything in the backfield. Good defensive call.
Ball is back at the 42. Third down and 10. Rutledge stumbling coming off the snap. And right there is number 60, Matt Millen, to pounce on him. The loss is back to the 45. And Alabama will punt again.
He almost lost it. Yeah, he's lucky to fall back on the ball in a situation like that.
And so the first quarter is history in this 1979 Sugar Bowl game, and there is no score between Alabama and Penn State. We begin the second quarter of play in the game here in the Sugar Bowl between top-ranked Penn State, number 2-ranked Alabama. Woody Humphrey is in to kick for Alabama on fourth down. Shoots it for the corner. Gets it this time. Beautiful kick. Inside the 4. 41-yard punt, and here are the numbers off the first quarter, and look at the yards rushing for Alabama.
81 yards, which is considerably more than any team made last year. The average last year, 55 yards. Time of possession, 10 minutes. for Alabama, and 36 seconds, only four for Penn State. They've got to make some first downs, and they're down, backed up where absolutely necessary.
Very careful down here. Bob Torrey, the fullback. Booker Moore is the tailback. Out of the I formation, just outside the three, it's Booker Moore running it up to the five, maybe the six-yard line. He is the quickest of the Penn State running backs. Notre Dame now has moved out to a 12-0 lead in the frigid Cotton Bowl in Dallas as Buchanan has run it in from a yard for the Irish. Bitter cold day in Dallas. At the six-yard line, it is second down and a long seven for Penn State. Double wide to the right side. Buchanan gives it to Moore. Hit behind the line of scrimmage. Marty Lyons and Wayne Hamilton pouring in to get him inside the five. Here's an All-American at work, number 93, Marty Lyons.
Marty Lyons is an All-American football player. You can see him just charge through, trying to get penetration, dives and leaps, and a great effort to stop Moore for a loss.
Ball is back at the three-yard line, where it is third down. It's actually third and 11 now, as it is at the three, rather than being sort of in between the three and the four. Out of the end zone, it is Torrey and Moore. And Buchanan's going to throw it out of the end zone. Now he unloads it to the fullback, Torrey, and Torrey comes out to about the 13. He's going to be close to the first down. Warren Lyles, the freshman nose guard for Alabama, had fought his way through the traffic and was in full pursuit of Buchanan in the end zone. And Chuck, calm, poised, senior quarterback, wanted to go deep. Instead, picked off his fullback, and let's see where the ball is exactly on the field. May want to bring the chains in.
Keith, that shows the poise and the confidence of Buchanan behind his own goal line. A game like this, he didn't get rattled. He found his alternate receiver, his safety valve, got the ball out to him, and nearly made a first down.
Just short. It'll bring up a fourth down, and obviously Penn State will punt. They're not going to fiddle around and give somebody the ball down there at this point of the ball game with 13:02 to go in the first half.
An interesting thing, Penn State's kick formation caused the Alabama coaches one solid week of preparation to know what they did. They're afraid of a pass, afraid of a run from this formation. It's not used by anybody else but Penn State in the country.
On fourth and a half a yard, Fitzgibbon will punt it. Ogilvy is deep for Alabama. Once again, Alabama should get very good field position. Fitzgibbon's punt, Ogilvy fair catch. First down, Alabama at their own 48-yard line. For Penn State, yet to really have much field position in the ball game, not giving them the opportunity to unwind their offense. Penn State undefeated, four times, never named national champion. Right now, we see for the first time in the ball game, number 10, Stedman Sheely at quarterback for Alabama. Good runner. Billy Jackson, the fullback. Travis flexes out to the left. Sheely pitches it outside. Off on the play. Ogilvy is trapped behind the line of scrimmage. Matt Millen boring in. Sheely was actually hit. He faked to his fullback and then was hit, but still was able to deliver the pitch.
Well, I think most of the time the coaches would ask Sheely, when he's hit, before he comes out clearly to attack the defensive end, keep the ball and take the loss. Don't take a chance on pitching. But Bear Bryant has confidence in this young man to put him in a game like this in this situation. He's done it in the past.
Loss on the play of three. Second down, 13. Sheely with it. Millen, the two big tackles, never gave him a chance to exercise the option.
Keith, watch Clark, number 54, just shoot the gap inside the tackle. Number 63, Bunch, is trying to block him to no avail. He has the quickness that when he sees that ball snap, he can penetrate, and he makes an outstanding play, and I'm sure is demoralizing the Alabama offense at this point of the game. And 60, Millen joins him.
So Stedman Sheely, peppered and salted, comes out. Rutledge is back in. The football is at the 40, where it is third down and 18, and Rutledge sends Ogilvy in motion. Brought Billy Jackson, the fullback, for the 45. That'll do it. And it'll bring up fourth down and a kicking down for Alabama with 11 minutes and 10 seconds to play in the second quarter. No score.
Keep. Penn State's defense have had their backs to the wall a little bit. Field position by Alabama, but Alabama could do nothing with it. Those two big tackles are just as we said, they are sensational.
They're also probably getting a little more feel of that wishbone.
Yes, it takes time. You cannot practice with a B team and simulate a great team like Alabama.
Humphrey's kick, another beauty. He almost hit the screen hanging in the roof. Suey catches it. Apparently hoping that they'd overrun him and he could bring it back, but no way, because Humphrey, Woody hung it up there 5 full seconds. Timeout. Big Bruce Clark there on the sidelines with his teammates, All-American in 1978 and the Chevrolet Defensive Player of the Year. Oh, only a junior. So is Millen, only a junior. All the coaches on the schedule of Penn State for next year trying to figure out right now how to handle them. Now in the Cotton Bowl in Houston. Houston's on the board in Dallas, I should say, as Davis is thrown to Adams 15 yards for a touchdown in the second quarter. That's a 12-7 ball game in Dallas. 10:42 to go here. There's Big Matt Millen. Penn State still poor field position. Back at the 12-yard line. Giacchino stands up to throw. He's got Bassett open, but he's running for his life. Now he dumps it. It is incomplete and almost intercepted. Murray Legg made a diving try for it. Giacchino running for his life, pursued by Curtis McGriff. And watch it.
Giacchino's trying to throw the look-in pass. They double-covered the receiver. They guessed correctly on defense. Alabama forced him out of the pocket. Giacchino throws, and the ball bounces right through off of his hands, up in the air. Watch Leg dive. Watch the effort right here. On the right of your screen, he came close. Would have been a sensational play if he could have grabbed it.
Penn State has not run more than any, in any possession, more than three plays. So it's been 1-2-3 kick. Throw it. And the gain is beyond the 15 by Matt Suey, a 211-pound junior from State College. And Mr. Bryant, thoughtful.
His team has had the best of it so far. They were ready to play. They've got good field position. They've been able, with their defense and kicking, to maintain field position and keep Penn State backed up. That's the mark of a good football team.
Joe Paterno has sent Bob Torrey in at fullback, replacing Suey. That's the tandem now, Booker Moore, the tailback. And Torrey, the fullback, on third down and 5 from the 17. Alabama expecting pass. Leg drops back into a deep position defensively. The pressure is on. Cross is after him. Hamilton got him. Wayne Hamilton, number 94, and Curtis McGriff, number 96. The linebacker Krause blitzed and forced him to his right, and he ran right into Hamilton.
The strategy, Keith, was that they showed the safety blitz. You've seen an audible to a pass. They changed and went back and double covered and put on a blitz. They knew he was going to throw the ball. They put on a blitz and got him for a big loss.
14-yard loss. And standing right at the very back of the end zone is Fitzke at the punt. Ogilvy to receive for Alabama. Once again, the Tide figures to get very good field position. Pressure on, gets it away. Ogilvy feels it. It'll be Alabama first down at the Penn State 41 with 9:09 to go in the second quarter. And Alabama continues to play on Penn State's end of the football field. This program, a special exclusive of ABC Sports. Let's pause 5 seconds. Tide comes up now with the first down at the 41. Lou Eichner and Billy Jackson sitting in the eye along with Major Ogilvy. That's Eichner flexing out of the wishbone. And they give it to Ogilvy, and Ogilvy runs it over the right side of the big center, Stevenson, and moves it down close to the 37 for 4 yards.
Keith, most people try to release their weak side blockers on a play to the left, for instance, but you better not do that on Clark. He's right over there. You better leave somebody home to block him.
Keith
key, however, go back to the very beginning where we talked about establishing the run out of the wishbone, and the key to that is the center's play against the nose guard. And Stevenson's doing the job so far. Here's the pitch. Ogilvy with it. He's inside the 35 to the 34, where Lance Mayo, linebacker, makes the stop.
Here we isolate on Lance Mayo, the linebacker, number 56, takes on a block, nearly gets knocked down, but then he scrapes off, makes the tackle on Ogilvy. Ogilvy after a nice game.
That time, Frank, Penn State had gone to a four-man front. Let's see how they line it up this time. You can see that Alabama is really pounding on the ground. Penn State almost nothing on the ground so far in this first half. Handed off to Billy Jackson, and Bruce Clark's got him. Clark and Donaldson, but it was Clark who made the first contact.
What do you do with a number 54? He weighs 268 pounds. He's quick enough to play the linebacker. He just walled his way through there and makes the play on the draw play on Jackson. Sensational continued play by Bruce Clark.
The football is sitting at the Penn State 38-yard line. It is fourth down and six. Humphrey to punt. Well, he's done a heck of a job. He goes toward the other corner this time, but he won't get there. Alabama puts it down. I think it was touched in the end zone, though. And they'll bring it out to the 20. Rick Neal was down there, but he lost his footing a little bit, was wobbling around, and hit the ball in the end zone. 7-11 to go. No score first half. The 1979 Sugar Bowl, settling the national championship on the field of play. Top-ranked Penn State, which has been held to only 8 yards rushing so far in the ball game by the Alabama defense. No score, however, in the game with 7-11 to go in the first half. Penn State's ball first down at the 20. It is Suey and Gooman lined up behind Fusina. And it's Gooman. And Gooman is out to close to the 25-yard line, running over the left side, running behind Keith Dorney and Eric Cunningham.
They got some movement that time. Keith on the left side of the line. They moved the Alabama defense back enough for Gooman to see a little daylight. Gooman and cut right through.
Gooman, like Suey, a little bit quicker than you really think at first blush. You can see how lopsided it's been so far in favor of Alabama, but there is no score. They've not been able to penetrate deep on the Penn State defense. Lions yet to get real good field position. And Suey this time gives them a first down, and suddenly they're out close to the 35-yard line with the first down.
Now, Keith, they're moving out a little bit where they can set up their passing and maybe take advantage of what the scouting report says Alabama is vulnerable to pass defense.
They doubled up that time on the middle guard and rode him out of there, and Suey cut right through the hole, and it's near the 35. Penalty flag. Screen pass for Gooman. It's a big play, but there's a penalty flag. All the way down to the 33-yard line of Alabama. But let's wait for the flag. There's a 31-yard gallop. Murray Legg, the strong safety, was blitzing, and he nailed Fusina after he had delivered the pass. But it'll come back. The referee, Bill Jennings, out of the Big 8, walking off the penalty against Penn State, illegal procedure, 31-yard gain wiped out.
Beautiful execution by Fusina on the blitz.
Hitting the back Gooman. Watch it right here.
Motion. White. Down one.
It'll be first down and 15 as you see the replay.
Screens are set up by the acting of the quarterback, and Fusina did an outstanding job right there as Romano, the left guard, number 53, was out in front of him to make the block.
Mike Clements in at cornerback, replacing Alan Crumbly for Alabama. Bob Bassett in motion for Penn State. Fusina gives it on a draw to the fullback, Suey. And Matt's up to the 35-yard line. That's just beyond the original line of scrimmage, so it's going to bring up second down at about 10.
Penn State averaged 25 passes a game for 11 during the season. Alabama coaches thought they might see as many as 40 or 45 because of the vulnerability of their secondary.
There's the time remaining on the scoreboard in the Superdome. Torrey is in at fullback now. Gooman stays at tailback. Torrey is a 226-pound senior, a little bit bigger, and they want him for blocking. Here's Messina, straight drop to throw. Fumble. McGriff stripped in with the ball. Oh, it's Braggs who stripped in with the ball, knocked it loose. Byron Braggs. And there was almost a crucial turnover. Penn State did recover the football and maintained possession as Romano, a guard in pass-blocking formation, saw his quarterback in trouble and came back to get the ball.
Watch Messina. They had the safety blitz. Number 90 is back in there. Forces it out of the pocket. Braggs, number 47, strips the ball loose. And number 53, Romano, the left guard, recovers for Penn State. A very outstanding effort on his part.
And the ball is all the way back at the 14. But fortunately for the Lions, they still own it. Got to go to the 40, almost the 45 for a first down. So they need 31 yards. Newman brought down at the 15. Braggs again involved on the play with Kraus 77 hustling over there along with number 90 Boyd. And it's fourth down, and once again Penn State Spitzky will have to punt from near his own goal line, and once again Alabama's going to get the ball in very good field position.
Keith, I've been a little bit surprised that Ogilvy has made a fair catch on every one of the punts by Spitzky, and he has had some running room.
They peel back for a return this time, and it's Fitzky's best punt, hanging it high and forcing him to call fair catch. He hung it up there 5 seconds. It was a 38-yard punt. Alabama's ball, first down. Some offensive talk on the sidelines along the Penn State bench. They've been unable to get on track. Alabama owns the football right now, first down. And it's close to the 47-yard line. Nathan is on the field, but they're not using him to return punts after he hurt that hip early in the going. Rutledge back to throw. Has good protection, hums it. And it is complete to Bolton. Bolton has it. First down at the Penn State 38-yard line.
Here we see Bolton, number 32, going down as if he's going deep. Gilsman is covering him and come close to making a great play. It was underthrown, but Bolton came back and wrestled the ball free in an outstanding play. Here is again a fake of the option play. Going to fake the fullback and then throw the pass.
Gain of 16 yards. Just inside the Penn State 38. Rutledge on the option. Wants to throw the screen. Gets it away to Whitman. Three blockers in front of him, goes for the first down. Jeff Rutledge was just planted over there by Matt Miller. But it was Mike Brock and Buddy Adelet out in front of the Alabama fullback, and it's a big play to the 22.
If one thing that will discourage a big rush is a screen pass and have success on it, and a screen back away from the flow is very difficult to defend against. Outstanding execution by one Rutledge.
See, Neal throw the first block, then Adelet, and then Brock. And it's first down at the Penn State 22-yard line. No score, 3:20 to go. First half, play goes into the middle. Steve Whitman, the fullback, carries. And he's inside the 20 to the 18-yard line. He got just about 4 yards on that carry. We'll call it three, and you see now time winding down. But Alabama's getting closer and closer, and most of this first half has been played on the Penn State end of the field. Second down, 7. Rutledge to throw it, looking for Pugh. Gets his pass off. It is intercepted. Intercepted by Rich Mullock. He may go. Only Ogilvy could bring him down. Only the foot speed of Major Ogilvy stopped Rich Mullock from going all the way. And suddenly, for the first time in the ball game, Penn State is deep in Alabama territory. Watch that's 54 here.
Now they've got two men on Clark. They've got Bunch and Brock. But here's Clark, forces the throw, and I know that Rusty pushes. He headed back. Now let's look at it again. Think of the option play. Here's Clark making him move to the left and throw off balance. Whitman deflected the ball, and Malott makes an outstanding run coming back in deep in Alabama territory.
A 55-yard return with the interception. First down Penn State at the Alabama 37-yard line. And don't forget, Matt Barr. Cusina hands it to Suri. And Matt Suri is hit head-on by linebacker Barry Clark. There's Malott, who made the interception.
That was a great play on Malott's part.
37-yard line, second down and 10, no gain on the carry by Suri. Penn State has not been able to run.